Hello everyone, this is Akuchi, back with some more Dominion. I'm going to be playing another league match, this time against Bryan. And we've played together quite a few times in the league. Open B division and A division. I think I've played two matches so far this season. Slightly behind even. So hopefully we can have a good one. Looks like this is Brian's first match. All right. Draw is a little bit awkward. We have archives, which are pretty good. Can armory for experiments, which isn't too exciting. There's also Baron as the only plus buy. Then there's Altar. I think we're probably going to play with Baron and just not trash all our estates. Archive can keep them like squirreled away, as it were. I think. Do we want a silver? Ultimately, I'm not sure what our payload is. I don't think there's enough plus buy for Fool's Gold to be really good. We could open Silver Baron, but there are some worse draws that way. I think I'd rather open Experiment Baron. We'll be able to get enough gains ultimately with Altar. But Baron's gonna help us spike 6 for Altar, for sure. Unless we get extremely unlucky. Okay, so this one's interesting. So playing this experiment, there's one terrible draw, which is double estate. Copper estate is probably most likely, and that's not great. But we could still get like an archive and still hit Baron with the state next turn. Double copper is great. If we draw Baron, that's great. Yeah, I think we play this. And we got to Baron. I don't know if we should get Slay. Fool's Gold. Let's get a Slay. Might get a bazaar as our first five. Nah, we still probably want archive. Slay does have the reaction. So if we combine it with Altar, that's not too bad. We can top deck what we gain. Just colonnade, just kind of awkward. Think ultimately we'll get some points there by buying archives or bazaars, but it'll take a while. Oh, we got some basilica points. We're gonna need to keep an eye on that. Yeah, I don't think we want silvers really. Oh, we have lots of terminals. I didn't realize that. So I think Bryan held on to an experiment. We need a bazaar. I don't know if we want another sleigh. I don't think so. Fool's gold, like. Man, we are getting these like extra buys. Sure, let's get one. Not much to do here. Double altar. Huh. I hadn't actually considered that at all. Yeah, it could be correct. Probably want an archive here. All right, we can get another bazaar and experiment. Going a little bit ahead. Not a ton. Okay. Think we want to draw more cards. Come on, bazaar. Got it. Okay. Cool. We can trash this estate. We probably need to. Falconer is pretty good for gaining experiments, right? Definitely better than Armory. Let's actually grab a Falconer Bazaar. And do we want another Bazaar or an Archive? Let's go with an Archive. We need to take that estate because we have our baron in hand. Fool's gold is kind of useless. Interesting. Bryan trashed all of his estates. A little surprised by that. We can't have enough stuff to trash if we don't take the copper here. It's an unusual problem. Let's grab a fool's gold. Let's put that in hand. Wait, what? All right, so I think I gained an experiment to hand. Okay, we got there. Probably we want probably just more bazaars, I think. We got a lot of landmark VP now. That bazaar in our archive is pretty clutch here. We might otherwise have a dud turn. Yeah, this turn will probably buy at least one province. All right, that's one game. That was our start. I think because we have the red text. Yeah. And It's a tough spot for Bryan indeed. More archive. Magpie and archive look like the only draw. Pretty useless. Capitalism. Hideout is the trashing. Little awkward, but not too bad. Looks like a pretty standard silver magpie opening. I'm gonna want to play with a bandit, I think. Probably. No plus spy. But archives. Pageant. Probably decent. Ooh, interesting. Hideout opening. I don't actually care about trashing all that much. I will play with a hideout, but I'm just gonna let Archive do its job. So I'll have three or four coins next turn. Probably Pageant. I will have four coins next turn. Maybe. Yeah, I actually feel like we want Pageant, and we just want to get all the archives. Hideout can come later, if at all. Look at the magpie. There's a chance that it proliferates. Didn't happen. That's okay. No plus buy, right? Yeah. Maybe I don't get a... one hideout is good. I think, yeah. One hideout is good. We have two archives. I think I want three. I mean, I want a lot. But I want a hideout and I want a bandit, I feel like. Probably. Maybe there's no time for the hideout. So, this is unfortunate. It looks like we got magpied. That's really bad. Don't really need this copper at all. Pretty sure it just doesn't ever accomplish anything. Alright, let's get a bandit here. Oh boy. Well, it's good to have those cards discarded, I think. They're not really what I'm looking for. I want to try to get these magpies going. And we did get another magpie. So here, I do think we want a hideout. We also really want archives. Where did that curse come from? Hideout, right. Well, that's it for the magpies. We didn't get them. Part of that is to be expected. Put some estate back onto the deck. That's annoying. Nice. One more archive, and then I think we're ready to province. I hope so. It's turn 10. Let's have this archive in reserve. Tough choice. Bandit on bottom. We could have avoided that. Probably want to trash one estate, if that's going to be correct. Fine. We're player two. I don't know, maybe we don't end up trashing an estate. Nice. Yeah, let's play the bandit. So I guess we don't? I don't know. We'll trash one. I don't mind a tie. There's a risk here. Like, do we take this magpie? Well, we can't take the curse, so there's no risk. And here we get the curse, and we can trash it. So, all good. Yeah, I think since we're ahead on the province thing, we're just in a dominant position. I think we have the win in hand. pageant was big. Yeah, maybe trashing the estate was riskier than it needed to be. Like, I didn't need to be that risky. If I hadn't been able to pair it up. Could have been a problem. Up 2-0. We've got goat and a 4-3. Magpie Pixie seems pretty good. So ghost ship. Strong card. The draw is a little bit awkward with Bandit Camp. Also, yet again, no plus buy. Now, Magpie is not actually likely to proliferate here. Still probably correct. I don't know. Like, we could get plot. Let's get plot. We'll get a magpie later. But I want to get a ghost town. Thinking about cashing in the plot here, but probably not. It's tempting, though. Very nice. Could get a magpie. I think that's pretty good at this point. And I think I'll draw. Well, we'll buy. Do we go after the castles? I don't think so. I think we have to contest Pixies, though. Because we do want to be in a position where we can get more than one province with Forest's Gift. Bryan's really going in for the Pixies. Wow, that was a really terrible draw. We are going to want a banded camp. Might as well take this opportunity to get it. Boy, that was a bad draw. All right, what to do? What to do? Think crown on spoils works. But yeah, I think I want one more band of camp. And then we'll go with a swashbuckler next turn. And we're gonna cash in our sinister plot here. Might not even be that necessary, but we don't get attacked. Are we gonna get attacked? Bryan hasn't shuffled their deck yet, so no, we're not gonna get attacked. Most likely. Ooh. Well, if that pixie gets trashed, we are getting attacked. Most likely. Oh, bad luck for Bryan. Okay. Let's draw. Oh, we didn't gain any magpies. It's definitely a question of whether we should hold on to spoils. I don't think so. Are we gonna province next turn if we can? Guess we could. Still, if we draw our deck, we really don't need it. So we could play to set up a magpie. Or we could play to maximize draw. Let's do the latter. Because that's the end of our turn, otherwise. Okay. I don't think that's sustainable for Brian. Then again, whatever I'm doing is not sustainable either. This will be a good turn. Down there we have Bandit Camp, Ghost Town. Yeah, I might just have lost this one. Well, here's something interesting. We can activate the swashbuckler if we want. It's pretty good. Let's do it. Spend the coffer to delve for a silver. No, we'll just keep around an extra copper, maybe. Seems fine to me. What does Bryan have in his deck? One silver. And one bandit camp. Okay. Nice. We've got our pixie. Looks like Bryan has two pixies. So that's unfortunate. I think there's a forest gift still in there. Be interesting to see who gets it. Bandit camp. Okay. Okay. So if we're gonna dance, which we certainly are. Should we dance with the castles? We need a pixie. That's kind of annoying. We definitely need a province. Do I spend all of these coffers? I think so. This sure looks like a turn we're using Sinister Plot. Okay, Sky's Gift. We should know what the last two are. Or the last one is. River. Sun? I don't know. Nice. Bandit camp, that's important. Yeah, son. Oh, interesting. What happened here? Bryan's got a chance to win, but I'm feeling pretty good. About taking that province. Feeling a little less good. Close one. Up 3-0 so far. Let's see if we can secure some more wins. Okay, Young Witch. Looks like we've got some options for draw. I think I like paddock. Probably. Yet again, no plus buy. In terms of trashing, we've got sacrifice, which is not great. Sheepdog as a bane is also not great. So I am strongly considering opening Young Witch. That is what our opponent does. Seems reasonable. Let's do it. Yep, that's the play. Womp womp. We don't get to put a curse into our opponent's deck. Problem. We also can't afford a four cost card. Problem. Double Young Witch. I don't like that too much. It's not a big deal. Oh, you know what we can't do? We can't even play the fishing village we bought. Maybe we can afford a four cost, though. Right, okay. Get a sacrifice. Sacrifices will need to be made. Ooh. That's pretty good. Feeling very behind here. I think that was a pretty costly famine, as these things go. Mole one of these fishing villages. Try to get to our young witch. We did not get to our young witch. We have not had the opportunity to buy a five cost. We might have a chance this turn. We might not. Yeah, we are. This is looking real grim. Would have been nice if we had a sheepdog in hand. Block that. Well. That was unfortunate. Ooh, we've got Advance and Border Village. That's pretty cool. Plenty of draw. Plus buy. Payload is a little weak. More than a little weak, but we'll try to make do. The trashing is monastery, but do we want to open monastery? So, I'm thinking we can get monastery later, potentially. Just rely on archives early. So, I'm thinking about caravan cargo ship. The caravan is pretty unimportant. Double cargo ship is, well, just setting us up for disappointment. Don't really need the silver with the cargo ship, I don't think. I'm happy to get some forecast cards. Let's try this out. I don't feel great about the opening. Well, this is very nice to see cargo ship here. We can get at a minimum an archive. We can get a border village and an archive. All right, so we're gonna get border village, gain a cheaper card, archive, cargo ship the archive. Ah, three estates in hand. At least we trigger this shuffle and keep them out that way. Oh, this was guaranteed. Whatever. All right, four cost. Another cargo ship is pretty good. I also like. I think I want a worker's village. I want that plus buy. Well, we can at least set aside one estate. Alright, so the things I'm gonna want a gold, and then I'm gonna want a pilgrimage, and those are things that I want. Okay. I'm very wrong about that. I had an estate in hand last turn. Well, I don't think we're gonna take advantage of our plus buy here. We kind of could have. Whatever. Another archive. They're good cards. This turn, we'll be able to take advantage of our plus buy. I feel confident. You know, I probably could have gotten a patrol there. Probably on multiple earlier turns. Yeah. I misplayed that. I misplayed that. We're gonna get a monastery and a cargo ship. I like this alternating cargo ships thing. No. Why did we get that third archive? I was so foolish. Look at this. Look at this. This is how I would like my deck to be. I'm actually really confused about how his deck was so good. Oh, well, Patrol found two estates, so that's something. Yeah, that was such a dumb third archive. I have so many villages. Why would I do that? Very foolish. Bryan is in a much, much, much stronger position now. Pilgrimage. Caravan. Okay. Well, I really want to see my monastery and other stuff. This is freaking ridiculous. Worker's Village, monastery, bottom deck. This is real bad. This is real bad. Still no gold for pilgrimage, but probably still a very strong position for Bryan to be in. Can't even afford any of the things that I want. How do we get to the point where we can afford things? We have to buy silver or something. Yeah, this is brutal. Don't know how to get back into this game. don't even know if copper is better than a state. Let's operate under the assumption that it is. We could absolutely fail to draw here. That is well within the realm of possibility. What we did there didn't make any sense, because we didn't buy gold pilgrimage. So what's the point of this gold? Not much point. Not much point. Should have gotten, like, silver patrol or something. Should have definitely gotten patrol silver. And then next turn, we could have afforded gold pilgrimage. Then the next turn, we would buy pilgrimage and get this stuff. But now we're not going to draw our deck, and we'll resign. That was really dumb. Really, really dumb. We played atrociously. Okay. No trashing. Governor, no trashing. Oh, we have a 2/5 grade. Well, you know, sometimes you're not meant to win. Yeah, plus buy is really good. Oh, I can get a governor. Duh. All right. Is winnable. Think we have four governors. Maybe we only have three. Probably we only have three. Right, we have to see the silk merchant. To be able to take advantage of all this extra money. Which we now have. Okay. Okay, let's think about this. How do we play so that we avoid losing? I feel like we have most of the golds. So, can we get four provinces this turn, though? I wonder. Probably not. So, if we can't get four provinces this turn, what is our game plan? So he's going to play another governor, I think, and that's going to gain gold. I just don't know how many golds he has. So he gained two that turn. Gained two on turn six. So he's got four golds up to that point. Then he gained a gold, trashed a gold, so he still has four golds. That's probably enough for Bryan to get five provinces over two turns, so I don't know how we win. He might have a dud turn. Like, that's a possibility. He's got a bunch of junk in the deck. I don't know, it's tough to say. I think we don't trash. There is a series sequence of draws where we win, I think. Well, maybe this has become more likely. Interesting. Interesting. I think if Bryan gets four provinces, I lose, yeah. Yeah. I played a governor and then I shuffled my deck. So I've got that governor. Now, if I gain four provinces, I'm in a really good spot. I think we have to go for it. And that's kind of the end of our ambitions, I think. Unfortunate. Well, maybe playing that bandit would have been correct. Okay. Does harem versus duchy matter? think we just want points. Well, good on Bryan for keeping his focus after going 0-3. All right, unfortunate finish. 3-3. Two more league matches remain for me. Hopefully, I'll be able to perform better. Until then.